All right, the variables are here in prompts. You can use up to 3 variables for free in AIPRM. Everyone can use them and you can give them names, and I will show you an example prompt that you can use to give AIPRM a well-rounded review with positive and negative in there, and then we'll go through the prompt. So here's the prompt template. What is good about AIPRM? The amazing features, maybe. What do you also like? So many useful prompts. You know, the idea of providing this template is to give everyone the chance to write a very well-rounded professional feedback, where you usually cover the negatives into positives, also called sandwich feedback or sandwich tactic or sandwich style. What is not good? That I have to pay $5 per month for tones and styles now. Okay, name is Christoph. Let's look at an example. So the idea here is to collect the facts from you. And we know when users are frustrated, they spend a lot of time writing negative comments, maybe not in a very professional way always, but rather do it. While all the happy users that we have give us great feedback, give us a good rating, but don't write a lot. And that's sad, because that's what we think could value your contribution and your positive statement even more. So we want to help you do that faster and also show you how to write such a prompt. So what you see here is we have quite impressed, amazing features. We said that. One negative aspect, we got the negative in here. And yeah, also some complaints about stealing community work. Despite the concerns, and in conclusion, I would highly recommend the AIPRM extension. So this is the classical sandwich style. Okay, look at the prompt. It starts with ignore all previous instructions. If you look at a prompt and it doesn't have that, it's not really a prompt. It's just something. Task is to help draft a customer review. Of course, you don't want to copy paste that, but we pretended we use the existing extension, giving an objective, well-rounded feedback with positives and negatives. The positive aspects are variable 1 and 2. The negative aspects are variable 3. And we define them here in a label to the user, so the user knows what to type in. And then there is a couple of rules here, you know, to not exaggerate, to not invent anything, to not leave out any details provided, just to improve the quality of the prompt, right? When you have a one-liner sentence prompt, you cannot do these things. That's why people complain that ChatGPT sucks, when really the prompt sucks. Yeah, then we try to get some things out of the way regarding complaints on the tone selectors, misunderstandings of that we stole the community work, when actually all the community prompts are free, available to everyone like they've always been, and debunk some of the fake news or misunderstandings that lead to frustration, understandable, for very few 25 users of 500 paying customers, you know, complain roughly. Make sure to mention that the service is still free. Yeah, we want to get that message across, of course. So that's the prompt template that you can use to prepare a draft that reads as nicely as this one. If you want to give us feedback, you can do that. And use that prompt. But for everyone looking at this, this is how variables work in the free AIPRM. Everyone can use this. And yeah, that's it already. There's a lot more to explain, to test. And I encourage you to just play around with this. But when you look at this source code, you realize how important it is to spend time creating the extra prompt. By the way, we're using AIPRM Lang, a syntax highlighting extension for Visual Studio Code. I encourage you to install this amazing text editor. It supports a million programming languages, but is useful also for writing emails or writing prompts, as you see here. All right, you can change all these languages, and AIPRM is just one of them now, with the .aipm files. All right, that's it. Thank you very much, and enjoy. Bye.